very good accuracy for biometric systems. Now, looking at a general biometric system, what exactly happens in this? You first do the enrollment, wherein you give your biometric. Here, I've taken fingerprint identification. You give it to the sensor. Certain features are extracted. Not the entire image is taken as a biometric, but certain features are extracted from the biometric, and it is stored in the database. When you are actually in real time doing authentication, you do the same process. You give it to the sensor. The features are extracted, and the features are matched with those stored in the database. So you get this. This is a general common biometric system that we use. In order to study a biometric system as to how good it performs, there are certain measures that we need to see, and they are a false match rate, which means it doesn't recognize a identity. So that is, it is falsely matching the person. There's something called a false non-match rate, which recognizes someone else's. And then you have some equivalent rate, wherein the two are equal. There will be some value over which will vary the two, and at some point, both of them will be equal. Both of them mean errors, both of them will be equal, and that point is called an equivalent rate. The lower the equal error rate, the better the system is. Now, before I move on to my own system, let us see how the existing system has been built. You have a fingerprint. You have certain unique characteristics on the fingerprint, which is called the new shape. Now, generally, manually, when the fingerprint experts in CBR or FBI, they try to match the fingerprints, they do it by checking these positions, numbers, and the type of the new shape. That is how it has been done. And people, when they try to automate the system, they try to do the same thing. So actually, it becomes very complicated to extract these new shapes in the automated system. Similarly, in case of palm print, the principal lines that you can see, they have tried to match those principles. So what our aim has been, not to see the fingerprint as only minutiae, but to view the fingerprint as an entire image. Because not only the minutiae are unique, but the entire fingerprint is unique as such. The direction of the ridges that you see here, that's unique. The thickness, the shape that they take there, everything is unique. So that is what we believe. The motivation of research such that we are able to improve the accuracy of the system, we are able to remove the spoof attacks that are possible. We believe that information lies in the entire image. If we think that way, that the information lies in the entire image, we feel that we can apply various imaging tools, analysis tools on this image, and hence we've tried to. Now, basically, we're concentrating more in transform domain. That's another way of looking at the image. I'll be explaining that. And the advantages of which are the transform domain removes noise and penalty. And it is insensitive to the variations of light while you are giving your fingerprint or your palm print. The variations in the light are invariant. It is invariant to that. And it is able to exhibit something called its energy compaction property. And hence, we are able to use it better. And this also I'll be explaining later. Now, of course, transform domain, there are many transforms which help us transform an image into a transform domain. What I've taken here is an example of the three Fourier transform. Both of these are actually the same, just a way of looking at the